What's up, everyone? AJ on AJ's Heli Journey here. I have found it a little difficult to find time to get out to the field, so haven't been flying much, but I did duck out today for a couple of late day flights. I think you can see from the video that the light was starting to go down, so I managed to get a couple of packs in. I only brought the raw 700 to the field, so I'm gonna walk you through what I'm doing here and what I'm thinking as I'm working on my Puro flips for this flight pack. The first couple here are just kind of to get warmed up a little bit, where I kind of am stopping in the inverted and then flipping back to upright. I think this one here is the first one where the progress I made today was that, or what I wanted to make today was to start doing them a little bit more continuously. So this is a process for me, you know, and I've gone through this step by step. So that one I think was the first one. I think the second one here was okay. But more importantly, it's just not pausing or pausing very little from upright to inverted and then inverted back to upright. So doing the full flip while pirouetting. These next two here were a little sloppy, and I'm going to talk to you about, you know, what's going on, at least for me. I can't, you know, maybe it'll help some of you out there who might experience it. So, you know, there's a process. The first thing I did when I started trying to learn this maneuver was just to get, see, that one almost got away from me, but just to get wrap my head around all the different stick movements, because it's completely different from, you know, just, you know, some of the other maneuvers out there, because now you're stirring the stick and now, you know, both sticks have to move, you know, at times independently or but in unison with each other. I know that sounds a little weird, but so getting the stick movements down was the first thing, but after that it's a bit of a toss-up as to which is more important. But you got to get the timing and also the amount of each input down, because too much collective, too little collective, or you know, too much cyclic in any one direction, it'll take you offline. So you kind of need to figure out just how much of each stick input to give, and that's what once you finally get it, that's what will get you to a point where you can control everything. The, you know, keep it stationary, control the altitude, and so on and so forth. So what you're seeing here, so today's focus for me, and I kind of just kind of split all these things up, today's focus was just to try and get be able to as best I can smoothly go from there, from upright to inverted, and then from inverted back to upright for a full flip. So you can see there was very, I did actually almost two in a row there. There was a slight pause between the first one. Now this last one here, I did the same thing where I did two full flips, you know, almost continuously. So there it is. There's the first full flip. Oh, no, sorry. That wasn't it. So here, this last one, you'll see. There, and then I'll go try to go right back into you the next one. So, you know, whatever, it's not pretty, but it's getting there, and I'm comfortable now, you know, flowing, you know, continuing the pirouette while I'm continuing the flips, if that makes sense. And it's just gonna take some time. Anyways, I hope I explained that well. Thanks for tuning in. We will catch you on the next one. Cheers.